Sharot?
Yes, Swamiji.
It is my wish to convert this mot into a chief center of spiritual practices and the culture of knowledge. The power that will have its rise from here will flood the whole world. A glorious passage to wisdom. Deoghar is the abode or ghar of the gods and goddesses. Deoghar is also known as Baidyanath Dham or Lord Shiva, and is an important Hindu pilgrimage site. It is one of the 12 Jyotirlingas and also one of the 51 Shaktipithas. It is one of the few places in India where the Jyotirlinga and the Shaktipitha are together, dwelling at the same place. Deoghar is a consecrated place, a Teertha Bhumi. Traditionally, it was a place where people used to come from far-flung places for recovering health.
Masamashai, good evening.
Good evening. Please take your seat.
Masamashai, I have heard that you visited Vidyapith.
Yes, with earnest request of Hemendra Maharaj, I mean Swami Sadbhavananda Maharaj, I visited Mihijam. From here, the Vidyapith started first.
Pranam Guruji.
And later, it is shifted to Deoghar. Deoghar is a very good place. There is Baba Vaidyanath Dham. Thakur also came here with Mathur Babu. That is a historical place.
Mathur? Oh, Mathur!
Bolo, Thakur.
Udao, dao, udit dao. Jive dhoya noi. Shivogyane jivo seva. Joy ma. Joy ma. Joy ma. Joy ma. Joy ma. Joy ma.
Masamashai, I have heard Swamiji also came here.
Yes, on several occasions.
During the time as a wandering monk and after returning from abroad as a triumphant hero, Swamiji visited this holy land a number of times.
Niranjan?
Yes.
Look. He seems to be suffering much.
Let's move.
Come. Niranjan, let us take him to Priyonath's house. Come on.
Yes.
Hold him. Pick him up.
Okay.
Hold. Careful. Careful. Slowly. Yeah. Yes. Yes. Come, come. Slowly, slowly.
Yes, sir.
Careful. Careful. Give me a glass of water. Thank you. Niranjan.
Yes, sir.
Bilaiye. Aap theek hain?
Haan, Swami ji.
Jivai Shiva. Narayan, Narayan.
Someone says, Swamiji had written his famous poem, Shakhar Pruti. Here?
Brahma hote kit paromanu, sharpo bhute shei premomoy. Mon pran shorir orpon karo shakhe, eshabar pai. Bohurupe shammukhe tomar, chhari kotha khunji chho ishwar. Jibe prem kore jei jon, shei biche ishwar.
Swami Vivekananda founded the Universal Temple in the name of his Gurudev, Sri Ramakrishna. The ideology of the Ramakrishna Mutt and Ramakrishna Mission consists of the eternal principles of Vedanta, as lived and experienced by Sri Ramakrishna Sisters and expounded and by Swami Vivekananda. The twofold aim of service activities, indeed, the whole ideology of the Ramakrishna Mutt and Ramakrishna Mission, has been put in a nutshell in the motto of the twin organizations, Atmano Mokshartham Jagad Hitayacha, for one's own salvation and for the welfare of the world, formulated by Swami Vivekananda.
If you want to rise again, we shall have to do so by spreading education among the masses. How can there be any progress of the country without the spread of education, the dawning of knowledge?
Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.
Hemendra?
Yes, Maharaj.
Come. Please sit down.
Pranam, Maharaj. Maharaj.
Hemendra?
Yes, Maharaj.
My mind is occupied by the thought of making an ideal residential school as Swamiji wanted. Education is the greatest weapon for awakening our motherland. You are the right man to do so, my dear.
Maharaj, I have a great desire, Maharaj, for meditation, bhajana, reading holy books. And in this way, I will spend my life. And after all, I have no ability and quality to take the responsibility.
No, 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 my dear. I tell you. You can do it. My blessings are with you. Don't say no, my dear.
Pranam, Maharaj.
After this, Vidya Chaitanya came to Belurmat. At that time in 1922, the first president of Belurmat, Swami Brahmananda Maharaj, gave up his mortal body. Brahmachari Vidya Chaitanya's mind was full of grief and restlessness. Suddenly, he went on thinking of the words of revered Swami Turyananda Maharaj.
You can do it. My blessings are with you.
He opened his heart to revered Swami Shivananda Maharaj, Swami Saradananda Maharaj, Swami Shuddhananda Maharaj, and Swami Nirvedananda Maharaj. Swami Nirvedananda Maharaj inspired him and promised to assist in the methodology of learning and teaching, as was in the Gurukula, where teachers and students come in close touch with one another. After long discussions with Swami Nirvedananda Maharaj, it was decided that the school would be established in Mihicham, in the then Santhal Parganas. Previously it was in Bihar, and now it is in Jharkhand state. From here, the glorious passage of Ramakrishna Mission Vidyapith began in the month of May 1922.
Two monks of the Velur Math with two other workers engaged a small house at Mehijam early in 1922 with a view to found a residential school over there. Initially, it was a daunting task for us. No ray of hope at all.
Don't be afraid of small beginning. Great things come afterwards. Be courageous. Are great things ever done smoothly? Without hard work, no noble work can be achieved.
Consequently, a hard struggle for existence ensued. The workers didn't know what to eat the next day, how to clothe themselves, how to equip the school, and even how to light the dark rooms at night.
Bhavati bhiksham dehi.
Sometimes, in quest for food, they had to roam about the whole day in the scorching heat of the summer sun. There were 12 residential students on the roll initially. After a few months, it was needed for its expansion keenly, and therefore we moved to Deoghar from Mehijam in January 1923.
There is no reason why sincere efforts should not succeed. The results are in the Lord's hand. Accept my good wishes and blessings. Well wishing, Swami Turiyananda.
In December 1923, Sri Arun Chandra Singha of Calcutta donated a big plot of land measuring 64 bighas to the Ramakrishna Mission Vidyapith and registered it in the name of the president of Ramakrishna Mission Belur. Miss Josephine MacLeod, a disciple of Swami Vivekananda, had a great role in acquiring the land. Deoghar Vidyapith is the oldest and one of the foremost residential boys' school of the Ramakrishna order.
Time, patience, sacrifice, hard work and adherence will must show. Vast banyan tree lies inside a tiny seed.
Deoghar Vidyapith is now a big banyan tree, a nationally acclaimed residential school for boys. The Vidyapith soil had been blessed by the hallowed visit of three direct disciples of Sri Ramakrishna initially. In 1923, Swami Akhandananda Maharaj came to Deoghar first for recovering health. After darshan of Baba Baidyanath Temple, he visited the newly opened Ramakrishna Mission Vidyapith.
Pranam.
Pranam.
How are you, my dear children?
We are very much fine, by the grace of Thakur.
All are well?
Yes, Maharaj.
Today I have visited Baidyanath Dham. Deoghar is very beautiful place. I am very happy to see the newly built Vidyapith. Thakur Ma Shamiji's blessings are with you.
Jai Prabhu.
Jai Prabhu.
In 1926, Sri Ramakrishna's image was consecrated by Swami Shivanand Maharaj on the Sri Panchami day. Swami Shivanand Maharaj's visit to Vidyapith was very memorable and significant. Mahapurush Maharaj inspired Swami Sadbhavanandaji and other founder monks to make the Vidyapith as man-making and character-building educational institute.
I visualize a great future for the Vidyapith. I am convinced that great work will be done through this institution.
Sri Ramakrishna's another direct disciple, Khoka Maharaj, Swami Subodhananda Maharaj, also visited the Vidyapith. One day, after taking lunch, when Khoka Maharaj was taking rest, suddenly, Sri Ramakrishna appeared before him and said,
Khoka, O Khoka, tu ekhono ghumiye achis? Deoghar train to chole elo re.
Jai Thakur, Jai Thakur, Jai Thakur, Jai Thakur, Jai Thakur.
Guru Sri Ramakrishna has shown him a boy in dream who was waiting for initiation. It follows that Deoghar Vidyapith is blessed by Sri Ramakrishna himself, his disciples, and of course, many other spiritual giants and the most senior monks of the order.
Yes, this is the boy. Jai Thakur. Om Namo Sri Bhagavate.
Lay down your comforts, your pleasures, your names, fame, or position. Nay, even your lives, and make a bridge of human chain over which millions will cross this ocean of life.
These are the prominent soldiers of Swami Vivekananda, who built a bridge little by little with their sacrifice, hard labor, and sincerity in the company of numerous unknown dedicated workers. Here is a list of Secretary Maharajas sequentially from its inception. Swami Sadbhavananda Maharaj, Swami Nirvedananda Maharaj, Swami Gambhirananda Maharaj, Swami Gyanatmananda Maharaj, Swami Adinathananda Maharaj, Swami Dhruvatmananda Maharaj, Swami Bodhatmananda Maharaj, Swami Raghuvirananda Maharaj, Swami Hiranmayananda Maharaj, Swami Pavananda Maharaj, Swami Shuddhasatvananda Maharaj, Swami Mitrananda Maharaj, Swami Chandrananda Maharaj, Swami Suhitananda Maharaj, Swami Suvirananda Maharaj, Swami Sarvagananda Maharaj, Swami Tyagarupananda Maharaj, Swami Jayantananda Maharaj.
We are celebrating the centenary of Ramakrishna Mission Vidyapith Deoghar in this year 2022. Vidyapith is grown up gradually by the sacrifice, dedication of innumerable monks, teachers, and staff members. I sincerely offer my devoted pranams, respect, and namaskars to all of them. I am fortunate enough to serve this institution. Swamiji wants man-making and character-building education. We try to follow this concept. We teach our students moral values in their ICB classes at school and in the night meetings at their hostels. We try for their all-round development through physical, mental, moral, and spiritual trainings.
In 1923, Swami Prakashananda Maharaj, and in 1924, Swami Bodhananda Maharaj and Swami Shuddhananda Maharaj visited the Vidyapith. Swami Shuddhananda Maharaj was very pleased to see the activities of the Vidyapith. After a few months, the governing body of the Ramakrishna Mission gave affiliation to the Ramakrishna Mission Vidyapith on 11th August 1924. Many distinguished personalities from diverse fields visited this illustrious Vidyapith from various parts of our country at different times and occasions and spread its unique ideals across the country. The great Indian freedom fighter, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, visited the Vidyapith in 1939, met with the students, and inspired them. A multifaceted talent, such as a mathematician, an upholder of science, and a nationalist, Acharya Vinoba Bhave, also came here in the year 1953. He is famous for his unique Bhudan movement. From the old diary of the Vidyapith, we can see that the legendary artist and writer Abanindranath Tagore visited this noble Vidyapith on 9th January 1928. Tara Shankar Bandopadhyay visited the Vidyapith in 1957 at the time of Swami Hiranmayananda Maharaj. The Universal Temple Consecration Ceremony was held in 1970 at Deoghar Vidyapith. Swami Vireshwarananda Maharaj, the 10th president of the Ramakrishna Order, dedicated the temple to Bhagwan Sri Ramakrishna. Ramakrishna Mission Vidyapith observed its golden jubilee in 1972. People from different places and classes attended the function and made the festival successful. In 1997, Vidyapith also celebrated its platinum jubilee in an elegant way. On this occasion, K.R. Narayanan, the then President Republic of India, sent a beautiful message.
The Ramakrishna Mission has rendered yeoman service in imparting value-based education to children in our country. On the auspicious occasion of the Platinum Jubilee of the Ramakrishna Mission Vidyapith Deoghar, I extend my warm felicitation to the monks, teachers and students of the Vidyapith and wish them all success in their endeavors.
Now, we'll see a vivid picture of the great Vidyapith as it stands now. Ramakrishna Mission Vidyapith is exclusively for boys and affiliated to the Central Board of Secondary Education, or CBSE. On 22nd December 1973, it was initially affiliated to the West Bengal State Board. Admission to its secondary section is restricted to Standard 6 only. However, a few students from other schools are also admitted to Class 11. In case the seats are available for them after giving entry to its own students who do well in Class 10 board examination. The school offers education in the science stream only in its senior secondary section. The boys are taken entirely on merit, ascertained by written, oral and other tests. A 2015 survey conducted by the Times of India placed Vidyapith in the fourth position among CBSE schools as per the overall average aggregate in Class 12 board examination. Ramakrishna Mission Vidyapith has been ranked first among all CBSE schools in India in 2020 based on the average aggregate score of the students in Class 10 board examination as per the survey conducted by a private educational portal. All the first, second and third positions in CBSE Class 10 board examination have been secured by Vidyapith students in 2020 in the state of Jharkhand. Students were felicitated by the Chief Minister of Jharkhand regarding this. In 2022, the first rank in Class 10 board examination and the second rank in Class 12 board examination have been secured by Vidyapith students in the states of Bihar and Jharkhand taken together. One student of the Vidyapith secured first position in the West Bengal Joint Entrance Examination in Engineering Stream in 2020. Students have also shown exemplary achievements in the National Science Seminar consistently and secured first position in 1998, 2006, 2007, and 2008. There are 12 dhams in the secondary section where students of different classes reside. Saradananda Dham, Matri Dham, Vivekananda Dham, Adbhutananda Dham, Brahmananda Dham, Yogananda Dham, Akhandananda Dham, Premananda Dham, Vigyananda Dham, Shivananda Dham, Subodhananda Dham, and Ramakrishnananda Dham. Students of the senior secondary section live in four dhams: Advaitananda Dham, Niranjananda Dham, Abhedananda Dham, and Trigunatitananda Dham. Nirbhaya Nilay. It's a heaven for children. Students play, talk with birds, rabbits, with the air and nature.
Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls.
They are now free birds. This tastefully decorated museum of the Vidyapith reflects the heritage of India. Unity and diversity, cultural heritage and religious harmony are beautifully synchronized in the museum. Our religious legacy, Vedic Rishi, Nachiketa, Krishna Balram, Lord Buddha, Ellora Caves, Bhagwan Mahavir of Jain Dharma, Adi Guru Shankaracharya, Ramanuja, Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Shri Ramakrishna, the latest and the most perfect, the symbol of religious harmony. We see a cultural diversity in the museum. Maria tribe of Chhattisgarh. Soligar tribe of Karnataka. Adi tribe of Arunachal Pradesh. Rajasthani tribe.
Ah,
Santhal tribe of Jharkhand. The Ramakrishna Mission always upholds the core philosophy of the Indian cultural and religious heritage. Within a week after the classes begin, Vidyarthi Vrata, a special puja, and Homa are performed where the students utter five pledges in front of a fire in order to build a prosperous future, strong character, pure mind, and sharp intellect. A student is expected to have a strong moral character, respectful to seniors, and be an embodiment of the ancient tradition of service and renunciation, the twin principles of our motherland. What an amazing and a joyful phase the hostel life is. All students are now in a big family. Vidyapith is their home, away from home.
As a student of Vidyapith, I would like to say that Vidyapith provides an environment conducive for the all-round development of a student. It develops students in every aspect, not only educational, but also social, moral, and spiritual. We keep learning minute things every moment, and this would obviously help us in future. We learn under the guidance of our teachers, Brahmacharins, monks, and above all, we have the holy trio, which makes our learning more efficient and perfect. Vidyapith is like my second home and as good as the first one. I love my Vidyapith.
We all love our Vidyapith.
Their daily routine starts at 5:15 a.m. by leaving the bed and end at night 10:30. Now, it is 5:30 a.m. for morning prayer. Exercise and drill by 6 a.m. AM, breakfast. AM, time for cleaning and neatness of their own rooms. 7:20 a.m. self-study in school. 9:00 assembly and classes begin by 9 a.m.
Class 9 move out. What is the democracy? Democracy is for the people, of the people, and by the people. Next, just let me see what are the elements of this democracy.
But they are found in the dense forest of northeastern India. It's an ape. Can anyone tell me what is it?
Yes, please.
Look, Gibbon.
Look, Gibbon. All right. Please sit down.
Now it is lunchtime, 12:30 to 1 p.m. After lunch, students get 45 minutes rest only, and then again the wheels run.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Now I would like to know from you what was the economic condition in brief, as brief as possible.
1:50 to 4:40 p.m. is an important time for them. In this period, their classes are scheduled.
Hits that velocity v, the remaining one. It is the one which flying away with that velocity.
Formal letter meaning any kind of official letter.
Vidyapith provides tiffin at 4:45 p.m. It is 5:10 p.m. Time for neatness and gardening. Now, it is 5:20 p.m. Most awaited time for the children. Whistle for play.
I have visited the Vidyapith 3-4 times and played volleyball with the students.
Swami Lokeshwarananda Memorial Football Match. Engineering versus medical students of the Vidyapith. Vidyapith has a beautiful gym for the students.
My child, what I want is muscles of iron and nerves of steel, inside which dwells a mind of the same material as that of which the thunderbolt is made.
They are now fully energized and a bit tired too. Yes, they get some rest. And then after, go to the Universal Temple for taking their spiritual breath. O Ramakrishna, you are an ocean of divine feelings, shining and always intoxicated with divine love. Your sight, which sees everyone as equal, showers divine love and removes the sorrows of the world. These especially blessed boys never forget the enchanting tune and the ethos of the song. O It is 7:15 p.m. Time for self-study. Dinner starts at 9 p.m. After dinner, a short get-together takes place for 15 minutes. And again their study begins and continues till 10:30 p.m. before night sleep. It's a rhythmic and systematic environment for making their lives as complete human beings. Dedicated monks and teachers try earnestly to help the boys to grow not only academically, but also morally and spiritually. They use Sundays and other suitable days for their extracurricular activities.
Bharat means Bha and Rat. Bha means knowledge and Rat means involved. The people who are involved in knowledge.
Today, whenever you go inside a home, you will see that the mother of the house is always shouting at the kids to stop using their electronic devices and do their daily routine works.
I'm the first to speak against today's motion.
What stirring eloquence expressed at this early age. It is not unlikely that they can be our statesmen. They will lead the country in the coming days.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Then, which session? Christianity was first introduced in India, in which place of India?
Sir, the region of Malabar Coast.
Margaret Elizabeth Malabar, the which religious leader is known as the Enlightened One? Enlightened One.
Sir, the answer will be Lord Buddha.
Students are in a laboratory, involved in experiments along with the teachers. Yes, they are the future scholars, scientists, engineers, doctors, architects of our motherland. We need technical education, as Swamiji wanted.
4, 3, 2, 1.
India is doing well in many branches of science and technology in the world. In space technology, India is doing remarkably and dominating in some areas. Vidyapith has a rich library for the students.
Fill the brain with high thoughts, highest ideals. Place them day and night before you, and out of that will come great work.
Digital library. Centenary Computer Lab, opened in 2022.
We just need to control the flow of execution of the statements.
I am very much fortunate that my child is studying here, the Ramakrishna Mission Vidyapith Deoghar. I am also impressed to see the educational system of the Vidyapith. I have seen that teachers, respected Maharajas, take care to each and every student so that they can grow in a complete manner. I am very much grateful to the Vidyapith.
Many accomplished ex-students visit Vidyapith, often to inspire and motivate the current batches.
Ek din, ek Maharaj ji, wo mujhe lagta hai class 7th or 8th ki baat hai again. Bahar se aaye aur hamare kaksha mein wo ghuse aur ghusne ke baad unhone kaha, main ek sawal karunga. Kaun jawab dega? सवाल बस यही था कि आप में से किनका किनका माइंडसेट ऐसा है कि चैलेंज को स्वीकार करना चाहते हैं और किनका किनका माइंडसेट ऐसा है कि नहीं, मुझे अपने आप को प्रूव करना है. तो मेरा निवेदन यहाँ बैठे हुए सभी छोटे भाइयों से है कि पहले तो अपने माइंडसेट को बदलो. यू डोंट नीड टू प्रूव एट दिस पॉइंट इन टाइम. जब अभी आप यहाँ बैठे हुए हैं तो आपको कुछ प्रूव करने की जरूरत नहीं है, क्योंकि यू विल हैव नेक्स्ट अपॉर्चुनिटी. एवरी मोमेंट शुड बी अ लर्निंग मोमेंट. आपके आसपास इंफॉर्मेशन बिखरा पड़ा हुआ है, सारी जानकारियां, सारे ज्ञान भरे पड़े हैं. मौका है आपके पास उन सभी ज्ञान को समेट करके अपने दिमाग में.
सुना था विद्यापीठ सोना बनाती है, पर ये गलत है. विद्यापीठ आपके जैसा हीरा बनाती है, आप ही के जैसा हीरा.
Music is the highest art, and to those who understand, is the highest worship.
Our country has a vibrant history in art and culture. Vidyapith upholds this tradition from its inception. Who can say that these young stars will not be our future poets and artists?
You see, Vidyapith is not mere an institution. It is an ideology, a philosophy, a way of life. It promotes a secular culture based on spirituality. It motivates us to manifest the perfection within. It motivates us to manifest the divinity within. And dear student brothers, wherever you are, always remember, you are of Vidyapith, you are by Vidyapith, and you are for Vidyapith.
Yes, Maharaj.
We all are very strongly bonded to our Vidyapith.
We see our Praktani brothers coming from distances to visit Vidyapith. These strong bonds reunite us together. We feel Vidyapith very much as our second home. I love my Vidyapith.
Vidyapith celebrates various programs according to its calendar, such as Republic Day, Independence Day, Saraswati Puja, National Youth Day, Teachers Day,
Happy Teachers Day,
Shivaratri, Bengali Poila Boishak,
Maharaj ki jai, Maharaj ki jai,
annual sports and others.
We went in, forwarded it to Secretary Maharaj. Now,
Vivekananda Balakendra is an arm of the Vidyapith. Its main objective is Daridra Narayan Seva, to uplift the underprivileged and downtrodden people of the society.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Sit down.
Thank you, sir.
This wing has different activities. Education for the uprooted children. Vocational education for the youth. And regular food distribution for nutrition among the poor. Ramakrishna Mission's first priority is serving the destitute, the poor, the illiterate, and the labor classes, as Swamiji directed. Vidyapith has a Sharada charitable dispensary that provides medical facilities to the poor and economically backward people. Dedicated monks, teachers, and wardens try to make the students self-reliant from an early age so that they can face obstacles and problems in future with courage, and they can become self-contained citizens of India. Ramakrishna Mission Vidyapith is self-sufficient almost in all aspects. This big dairy farm provides milk and milk products to students, staff, guests, and monks. And the byproduct is used for making natural biogas that saves the fuel cost of the huge kitchen of the Vidyapith. Vidyapith has its own salon, tailoring, cloth calendaring, and shoe repairing facilities in their campus. Vidyapith has its own bakery that produces delicious cakes, biscuits, and sandwiches for the children and others.
Arogya Bhavan, where students get their medical facilities. Students get all facility inside the Vidyapith campus. Completely dedicated workers do their daily routines silently, like dew falling at midnight. They are the true soldiers of the holy trio. Students practice meditation and yoga on a regular basis. These bring concentration of the mind. The very essence of education is concentration of mind, as Swamiji said. Swamiji dreamt that Indian students would one day combine the excellence of Western science and technology with Indians' spiritual culture based on inherent divinity in all human beings, and will be ideal citizens of their motherland. Deoghar Vidyapith is a mini India. Students come from different parts of India, and it reflects the core philosophy of our motherland: unity in diversity. First of all, we are Indian. After coming here, they are like brothers to each other, and very shortly, they build a selfless and strong bond. And this rapport continues unto death. Swami Suviranandu Maharaj was once the secretary of the Vidyapith, and now he is the general secretary of the Ramakrishna order.
When we look at the Ramakrishna Mission Vidyapith Deoghar today, we are reminded of the prophecy of Swami Sivanandaji Maharaj, more popularly known as Mahapurush Maharaj, the second president of the Ramakrishna order, as having said, I quote, "I visualize a great future for Vidyapith. In due course, great work will be done by this institute. This year, our Deoghar Vidyapith is witness to its centenary. Today, we shall certainly rejoice, but at the same time, we have to introspect. We have to look both backward and forward to recapitulate the retrospect and to visualize the prospect. We have to reflect upon our failures and relish our successes. We have to do soul searching and identify the space for our weaknesses and how to go forward and keep pace with the spirit of education of the day. Our education must be a well-balanced blend of the East and the West. Well, all my good wishes for this great seat of learning, one of the finest academic institutions in our country. All the best to everybody. May the choicest blessings of Lord Buddhanath profusely shower on the institution overlooking the historic and grand temple of Baba Buddhanath."
100 years of Vidyapith!
It was conferred the National Award in 1986 by the Government of India for the works in the field of child welfare. Gyani Jail Singh, the then President of India, handed over the award to Swami Suhitananda Maharaj, the then Secretary Maharaj of Vidyapith. Now, he is one of the revered Vice Presidents of the Ramakrishna Order.
I consider myself fortunate that I had the privilege to be associated with an institution which has got the hallowed memory of a few illustrious Brahmaganis. You will find the picture in the inception of the Vidyapith under the mango tree. That was the start of the thing. And today, to what dimension this institution has come up, we all are seeing. This institution was an experiment. And on this research of that, Nandapur, Purulia, Mysore, and Coimbatore, so many institutions sprang up, not only of Ramakrishna Mission, but throughout the world. And today, this man-making and character-building education has become, to some extent, some common slogan for all the institutions throughout the world. So naturally, the students, those who would come out from this institution, they have some moral legacy and moral duty. That means through their life, they should spread the voice, the higher thoughts, which has been, for which purpose the institution has been started. I pray to Thakur Mother and Swamiji, especially Hari Maharaj and Shivananda Maharaj, to shower their blessings on those who would pass out from this institution.
Deoghar Vidyapith is an institution that quietly thrives by its own strength of a long-standing tradition and a deeply spiritual ambience hovers over the blessed place. Therefore, we get a clear picture of the foundation of the Vidyapith and its steady growth that leads to a glorious passage to wisdom. Guided by the spirit of Sri Ramakrishna, the Holy Mother Sarada Devi and Swami Vivekananda, and with the blessings of many illumined souls, this premier institution has made wonderful developments from its infancy. In the 100 years of its existence, Vidyapith has grown both in size and in the nature of its activities. Not only 100 years, but also the wisdom that radiates from this unique Vidyapith will extend to eternity.